Hey, what's up guys, aarava here, and welcome back to another episode of my F1 23, My Team Career Mode. This is part number 78 today for the Spanish Grand Prix in Season 5. If you guys did miss the previous one at Imola, then definitely go check that one out, as it was a blockbuster race. All the way to the end did the race win go. The threat of rain came, but never really appeared, but we didn't need it. The on-track action was amazing enough. Sonoda, the driver of the day, outside the top 10, managed to be fighting for the win. Fighting us for the win on the last few laps. And, you know, for ourselves, also, we had to make our way through after a difficult start with Russell dominating the first part of that race. So, you know, a very slow burner in a way, all building up to a big crescendo at the end, a titanic battle with Tsunoda. And honestly, he would have been a worthy winner, but we were able to secure and fend him off and secure that first win of the season. And it came at a very good time where Teo Pourchaire wasn't scoring as much. He also started outside the top 10. But unlike Tsunoda, he struggled to actually make his way through and had a bit of a slow burner Grand Prix. Eventually got a couple of points, but, you know, we are seeing a little bit of a lapse in that kind of, you know, insane pace and dominance that we saw from him at the start of the season. I mean, because of those two wins to kick off the season, he still leads the championship. He has done ever since those two wins. But the gap is closing now. Tsunoda is the closest man to him, though, in second place. He's actually vaulted over just about ahead of Leclerc by 1 point. Obviously, our win now gets us a bit closer to Leclerc and firmly in that top four fight. And then there's a bit of a gap to the rest of the pack because, you know, all those other teams really are yo-yoing about. You know, one race, you know, Drogovic is winning a race and now he's had two 10th places and a fourth place. Fittipaldi, though, his teammate's actually been quietly consistent, you can see down below. And then, of course, the other teams have been very much yo-yoing. Mercedes, you know, they're either getting a podium or not. Or, you know, the same for Red Bull and McLaren. It's very tight in terms of every team seems to just not want to be consistent, basically, outside of Aston Martin and ourselves, which is good news for us. But obviously it means we need to stay wary because maybe at one point one of these teams can start to become consistent and then all of a sudden you've got three teams or four teams involved in the championship fight. But right now the focus is on Aston Martin, and for us really just the focus is having won that race, try and build on that really. Get, you know, try and work our own momentum as we know the AI love to do with the way the coding works with the, you know, focus levels, etc. And with that we come into the Spanish Grand Prix race weekend with a bit of confidence, of course, overcast conditions on Saturday, but I don't think there is any rain actually to come at any point, but just a bit doom and gloom it's looking like. The sun will come Sunday, but just might mean a little bit of a colder circuit here in quali, which might favour, you know, a couple of other teams compared to others. We're going to have to really find out as this session goes on. It actually looks like maybe it did rain earlier in the session because the track surface looks a little bit patchy in places. But this first flying lap, a bit of a banker, gets us close to Pourchaire, but the second one we start cooking a little bit in the first sector to purple, green the second, through the final corner trying to scrub off the least amount of speed and maintaining that 4/10 advantage that will get us up into second place at that point in time. Eventually others do set laps, but it doesn't matter, we're just trying to get through into the second part of qualifying. Of course, Russell looking good up there for Mercedes once again, looking quick, but will that translate to the rest of the day and indeed in the race? But Drogovic, Schumacher, Gasly, the top four. Very interesting, eclectic mix of drivers in the top four there. And then Leclerc was the kind of familiar name in P5. So kind of hard to tell where this car stacks up right now versus the grid around Spain. But what I can tell you is, at the moment, it's not stacking up anywhere. Massive mistake for us. And to be honest, it's the return of the marbles. I had some massive amount of marbling on the left-hand side on the left front tire as we went a little bit wide, which was my fault, but then the marbles are so unforgiving here again in Spain, like they are in Bahrain, kind of, so that caught me out. Thankfully, we're fueled up for two flying laps, so we go again on a consecutive run, 5.8 seconds up, but it will mean we're up to fourth place, of course, that delta time being compared to last the first lap. But we're through, we're just about through. If we had lost maybe 0.04 of a second, we would have been out of Q3, it looks like. And Théo Pourchaire, for the second race in a row, is out. The championship leader is out in P14. Sainz, Tsunoda in P12. Once again, Tsunoda and Pourchaire, the two that were out in Q2 in Imola, are out again. Is it going to be a carbon copy? I'm getting a lot of deja vu here. Is it going to be Tsunoda and Pourchaire charging up and Tsunoda once again fighting us for the win in the Spanish Grand Prix come Sunday? I mean, if that is the case, I would love that. But they're very, very peculiar. So the only two in the top four who made it through are myself and Leclerc. Obviously, both of us, third and fourth in the championship. Tsunoda, second and first. So this is quite ideal for the championship fight in terms of me and Leclerc chasing after, our respective teammates, actually, really. So, yeah, but very, very odd. And, you know, really well and truly, Pourchaire, after such a strong start, you know, obviously, he's still a very young driver. You know, it's only his third full year in Formula One, so... You know, if this was real life, you'd say maybe, you know, kind of, you know, soared to the top quite quickly and then maybe destabilized and couldn't kind of keep up with that pressure of delivering that sort of result all the time. And so here again, has to watch from the sidelines. We've got two Haas cars in this session as well and two McLaren. So maybe some of the old guard of this series are returning to some form. And of course, the two Mercs were 1-2 in that Q2 session. So here in Q3, let's see how we go. It's pretty much stayed the same level of overcast, so it's really the same sort of conditions, but I bet you that our competitors around us will be speeding up as they always do. The first flying lap is in P7 at the moment. We have again fueled up, or the minimum fuel we've got in this on this circuit allows us to do two flying laps in a row. So we go again. We're just about 1.5 tenths up in the first sector, purple first sector, but we somehow scrubbed off speed in the second, and then in the last sector get hit with a wall of understeer, hit the marble line on the right hand side, and we have to back out of that because the rear end stepped out there. So a little bit of a disappointing end to that second run, although to be fair, I don't think we would have been improving. And then, unfortunately, I've timed this just about incorrectly. We needed probably 5 more seconds to do this outlap, to start the lap. We've gone wide anyway because there was so many marbles on the final corner. And that is our qualifying over. We've actually ended up qualifying higher because as I loaded into my flying lap for that third run... it seemed like some lap times got deleted, maybe for track limits or something, because the order changed slightly. But we remained, you know, with our same lap time. But P5 then, Felipe Drugovich. Hang on a minute. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Hang on a minute. I didn't even realize. I was too busy talking about myself. Felipe Drugovich. Pole position for the Brazilian. What? What a result for him. Verstappen second place in the Ferrari. Albon and Russell. McLaren and Mercedes. 3 and 4. Very interesting mix-up. Myself and Leclerc, the two closest in the championship here in the top 10, close together on circuit. But a very interesting front end of this Spanish Grand Prix. This, I don't really know how to call this at all. We've got, you know, 6 different teams taking up the top 6 spots. This could be quite something. Let's go to the grid.
Welcome along, everyone, to sunny Spain, specifically to the Circuit de Barcelona-Catalunya. So many great moments in Formula One history have been written at this very track over the years, including Michael Schumacher's first win for Ferrari back in 96. That win was in the rain. We might have better weather here today, but we're just as overjoyed to be at the Spanish Grand Prix. It's an updated track at Catalunya, and the popular opinion in the paddock is that we never wanted the chicane in the first place. That's now been gone, the final corner is much faster, and at 2.9 miles and 14 turns, we await the Spanish Grand Prix. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Felipe Drugovic lines up on pole position, edging out Max Verstappen, who'll start from P2. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Albon, Russell, the owner driver, Leclerc, Bottas, Fittipaldi, Norris, Oscar Piastri, Sainz, Tsunoda, Liam Lawson, Gasly, Mick Schumacher, Ocon, Ricardo, Perez, Théo Pourchaire, Joe, Sargeant, and Kevin Magnussen fills the last spot on the grid. It's it's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track where preparations are underway. And joining me again for the race today, Natalie Pinkham. Let's have a chat about Williams. What do you make of their performance so far this season?
Well, the atmosphere within the team seems very positive at the moment. Everyone seems like they're in great spirits and having a lot of fun doing what they do. And that has definitely contributed to the performances we've seen.
So potentially we want an answer to why our teammate Terry Porcher is out in Q2 for the second time now in a row, as the top 10 remains pretty much the same. But we've got Porcher down in 19th place. So he's taken a grid penalty, so maybe those worn components were hurting him in qualifying, and he's only now then taken that penalty, because that happens quite a lot often when one of the AI, you know, just doesn't perform as they probably should do compared to previous results. You know, sometimes it's not a surprise when then they're down further because they've taken a penalty. So sometimes I think the AI still use the worn components in quali and then take the penalty post-session. So I think that's probably what's happened there. Either way, Porcher's now got even more work to do from 19th place for us. We are alongside Leclerc, 5th and 6th place here today. But Felipe Drugovich, the Brazilian in the Alfa Romeo Haas, on pole position alongside Verstappen. Very, very interesting starting grid for this Spanish Grand Prix. We go to 5 red lights and we're underway here in Catalonia. 33 laps ahead of us, and it's a good start versus George Russell. But then moving about, trying to find some space on the inside of Verstappen, but Albon is there annoyingly just to block that off. I had to be wary that he was going to be late on the brakes and coming in hot, and it would have been a pinch moment, so we've had to just play a bit cautious there. I could have been more aggressive, but just wanted to make sure we're intact here. And so we stay in P4 behind Albon, Verstappen second place, and now we have an opportunity. So here we are, the patience is going to pay out for us, because now we can overtake our fellow compatriot Albon in the McLaren and get up into third place. Drugovich, though, still leads the way, and you'll notice we are the only car, really, who started in the top 10 on the soft compound tyre. Obviously, everyone outside the top 10 has a free soft compound to use because they didn't use one in Q3. But I actually saved a soft tyre for this very reason, to try and be very quick at the start, because I know the strategy is going to be whatever you start on, probably going to a hard compound for ourselves here at Spain. It's a, you know, very high deg circuit, so I knew that was going to be the case. But if we are doing that, we may as well go really thick and fast at the beginning of the Grand Prix on softs, basically, to do that. So we've gone a bit different, as we're seeing a lot of overtaking going on here, and it's all really to do with the Audi cars. Sainz overtakes Leclerc for P5. It's been a bit of a slow, quiet start for Leclerc, and Gasly unable to overtake Albon, and actually Albon going way down the order. This is having been overtaken by me. He's actually just fallen away, basically, because once I overtook him, Russell got him straight away, but then he's just fallen back and back and back. And he's now down to P8. Gasly's got him. And Sainz books in that overtake on Leclerc. So the two Audis are starting to look very good in this Grand Prix. And Tsunoda, he's already up into P9. It's only lap 2. He's on the softs as well. Everyone outside the top 10 was on softs. So I'm hoping that Porcher can get a move on. He's already up to P18. But that's only one position higher than where he started. Whereas Tsunoda, I mean, what is this guy on? Once again, he is cooking. Tsunoda is up to P8 then from P12 in 2 laps. I honestly think if we're here in P3, it's starting to feel a major deja vu from Imola. The big difference, though, is at the moment we have a Haas leading the race and Verstappen in a Ferrari in second, chasing after, looking a bit rapid now, and he's got DRS open. And this time, I think he can actually make a move, because he did try it on the last lap, but he was nowhere near making a move. This time he went from left to right, but he's been held up. Drugovich, really good at defending there in this Haas. Obviously, he's used to defending a lead, because he did just that in Abu Dhabi when he won that race in round 3 of this season versus Porcher. And he's defended Verstappen so much so that maybe I could have a run at him, because we're now in DRS of these two. Drugovich is constantly blocking Verstappen, and at the moment we're doing well just to keep up with him, but we can't really make an inroad just quite yet. But to be fair, just waiting for the right opportunity, because we need to also not press these soft tyres too quickly. But saying that, Gasly has set a fast lap for the Grand Prix. He's also on softs in the Audi. And look at the minimap and look behind us. He's actually closed up to us. So Gasly might be arriving on the scene thick and fast on a set of soft tyres. So we need to now make this move on Verstappen, because otherwise, sooner rather than later, Gasly could be on the scene making a mess for us and overtaking Russell and Verstappen. We do overtake the Dutchman to get up into second place, and now setting our sights on Felipe Drugovich. And you think on the soft versus medium, surely I've got the pace, but now the tyre wear starts to creep in a bit. And to be honest, really just a weird thing of, as soon as I got Verstappen, the car just felt so awful in the last sector. I think maybe I overused the tyres a little bit, you know, overtaking Verstappen. Maybe there was a little bit of temperatures involved. But now all of a sudden, because I've lost the back end a couple of times, I've got three cars on me. Verstappen and Gasly all of a sudden are on my inside. What the heck is going on here? Gasly, he has arrived like I said he would, and he's ruined the party. He's messed everything up. He's now in second place. How has this happened? We're down to fourth place. We're going to dive bomb Verstappen, because at this point, I've had enough of watches the curve there. I should have been attacking Drugovich. Instead, he's got a 2.5 gap now. And Gasly, of all the people, he's the one up here, and he's in second place. Brilliant stuff. So Gasly showing us how to use the soft compound of tyre. As was the case when we were teammates quite a few times, Gasly would be the one to show us how quick he is versus ourselves. And he's doing it again, annoyingly, here in Spain, as we watch now on lap 9. Tsunoda, that is, overtaking Verstappen. He's into P5. That's mad. He's gone from P12 to P5 in 9 laps. He was not this high up in Imola at this point in the race. I think Tsunoda is looking for revenge, you know. Even though he started outside the top 10, he's looking for revenge on me, maybe, or just the entire grid, basically, in terms of a race win. Porsche is up to P12, though, so that's good to see. So he is actually making a bit more progress than he did at Imola as well. So both Tsunoda and Porsche doing well on the soft compound attire. But another person doing well on the softs. Really? Gasly? Gasly's overtaking Drugovich straight away. He's also doing well on the softs. I'm the only one now struggling on these soft tyres, as is the case a lot of times on this game, really, is, you know, the soft is good for me when the tyre wear's there. Then once it starts going off, it's a little bit iffy, and obviously the medium is just an absolute dud of a tyre for us. But we're going to make no mess of overtaking Drugovich, because at this point, I was... Well, I'm not going to lie, quite angry the fact that Gasly had got into first place of all people. And so I was laser focused on keeping up with him. And I am keeping up with him. And we're within 1 second still at this point. We've got DRS. And on lap 14, we're gaining. I've only got one target, and it's overtaking Pierre Gasly for first place here. Dive down the inside. Gasly gave us a squeeze. Nearly banging tyres as we're still neck and neck. But we get ahead through turn 3. But Gasly is actually just saving battery maybe for a dive now through to the inside for the next right-hander as we end sector 1, go into sector 2. Marbles on the tyre, so having to watch out for that, and also having to watch out for where this Audi is. We lock up, we go wide, and we actually take Gasly wide with us, and that invites Tsunoda? Tsunoda of all people, I invite Tsunoda in, apparently. He's in P3. Oh, that's crazy. That is mental. As we continue. So we're now going to be apparently defending Gasly, our bitter rival, and Tsunoda looking for revenge, maybe, from Imola. Gasly, so quick on the outside. We lock up. The marbles are killing us out here as we keep going wide. Gasly on the inside. Oh, he's turned into us. He's turned left through a right-hander. Are you kidding me? Pierre Gasly and myself have come together. Is it no shock? No, it isn't. It was obviously bound to happen. Unbelievable. What the? Someone crashed. Safety car. Oh my God. Sainz. I think he crashed into the pit lane, you know. I think he's just crashed into the pit lane. Safety car. Oh, red. No. Red flags out. For the second time this season. Whilst we make a pit stop, the red flag comes out. At Bahrain, it was as we exited the pit lane. And now it's got worse. This was as we entered the pit box. I actually can't believe our luck when it comes to this. This is actually ridiculous now. That's so unlucky. For the second time, at least this time I wasn't down the order. So I actually might still start this red flag restart in like the top six. But this is why then. So Sainz was coming in with us, but Sainz basically, he just had to step out of it because I was overtaking him going in. But he's coming in. He's coming in with me. But he's already half a car length behind me. So he had to be the one that backed out of that. But he's then hit dirty air behind me. And he's understeered into the wall. Because he wasn't turning left. It wasn't like I took him into the pits. He was actually coming in on that lap as well. And the dirty air has just put him in the wall there. Unlike Bahrain, that red flag is, inadvertently, is kind of because of me coming into the pits next to Sainz there. But at the same time, I feel like that's still massively unlucky. Like, even a safety car would have been, okay, whatever, you know, a little bit unfortunate. But a red flag, I mean, to be fair, a safety car there could have probably screwed us over even more, actually. Because the way this red flag is going to work is, I think because we were still around P5, 6 when it dropped, we will be able to start the race, I think, in the top 6. I'm hoping. But I'm hoping some of you will notice that this red flag strategy screen is actually glitched. For some reason, it's showing me the entire race. Like, look at that. It's not showing me the first stint. Like, this strategy screen looks like I'm about to start a full Grand Prix. Like, why can I change my first stint? My first stint was on softs, so it stays softs. So I don't know what's going on here. I was worried that I've changed the second stint onto hards because that's the second stint. You know, the red flag restart's going to be lap 17. That pit stop window, is before the red flag. So I set that to hards. But I also noticed that the first stint, it's acting like that's the start of the race, even though it's basically glitched. But I put that on mediums, not on softs, just in case it puts us on that first tire. So I want to be on the hards, but I have a really sneaking suspicion it's going to put us on mediums because it's glitched for some reason. But I wasn't sure, so I kept the second stint on hards because logically that should be the tire we're put on. We confirmed the race strategy, but as I suspected, it's glitched and I've been put on that first stint tire. Thank God I switched that from soft to medium. Is lights out and away we go. We have started in P7 and both Mercedes cars just don't get off the line. It's a howler for the silver arrows. Tsunoda's come for the overtake for P4, for P3 even, on Max Verstappen. It's a very hectic start, I must say. The two Mercs really literally didn't get off the line. I think they slowed up a lot of people on that starting grid still, as we are now actually having a go at Tsunoda because he's got it all wrong. As I thought he finished off the move on Verstappen, but we've actually now got ourselves side by side and it's turning into another little epic duel with the Japanese driver. And we overtake the Aston to get up into P4, but we should be doing so because we're on the mediums and they're all on the hard tires. So it would seem like the strategy is glitched for everyone. And so basically everyone that was on softs has gone to mediums because that's like the default, I guess. And then everyone else that was on mediums has gone to hards. But I have a feeling that they wouldn't have done that maybe if it was a normal strategy. Like, I feel like some of those, you know, soft tire runners, if you know what I mean, would have gone on hard. So, including me, as we overtake Drugovich, we waste no time getting into second place because we now basically need to make the most of these mediums to chase after Gasly. But we know that, you know, this my team car is better on hards. I would have preferred to be on hards because the pace might be here now, but as soon as there's a little bit of tire wear, these mediums are so awful for us and for our teammates generally as well. So even though Porsche has just done very well to overtake Tsunoda, things might be getting worse for us as a team. But for a second, let's just admire the fact that Porsche now, for his sake, has got back into this race. The red flag for him has worked wonders because now it's him and Tsunoda in the top six. So it's a valiant recovery because Porsche was down in 19th, whereas Tsunoda was P12. And as I was just complimenting Tsunoda's race, it's misery for his teammate Leclerc, the Aston that was actually ahead on the starting grid in this race. is out of this Grand Prix. He's got some sort of mechanical failure. I mean, to be honest, at the red flag restart, Leclerc was down in 21st place, so the race wasn't going well for him anyway, but it's now just adding to that misery, and clearly he was just doing the entire race with some sort of issue. Maybe that explains why Leclerc was falling down the order, but for me then, in this, this attempt to try and catch Gasly, we're losing time. We're losing 0.3 to Gasly, and we're pushing hard to try and keep up with him. And we push too hard, apparently. We push too hard over that sausage curb on the inside of that quick left to right hander. And we've got diffuser damage, rear diffuser damage, and it's going to affect us a little bit. I was unsure how much it would affect us. But on lap 23, you're seeing here, it's actually affecting us quite a fair bit because the rear end snaps once, it snaps a second time, and through the final corner, we're just not as quick through there. I can't carry as much speed through these corners now. So legitimately, that rear diffuser damage on that curb is really hurting us. It may not look like it in most corners, but the really quick ones in sector 3 really hurting me. And we're not carrying the same amount of speed. And Drugovich now is on the back of us. And Gasly, well, it's gone from 2 seconds to 3.4. It's probably going to be 4 seconds, in a lap or two's time, as Drugovich is a quarter of a second behind us. And we're looking in the mirrors. We're not going to get spooked by him on the inside. We're not going to defend thin air, but we are having to be a bit concerned about where Drugovich is, basically, because he's getting quicker and quicker, and we're getting slower, because I think the damage is getting worse and worse as we go over every curb, and Drugovich now is on the outside of us. That Haas is actually attacking us. It's the combo of rear diffuser damage, and remember, these mediums are going off compared to the hard tyres, and we're still now side by side. Drugovich is trying his hardest to recover at least second place. He's lost P1 from his pole position. Gasly looks to be maybe booking this one in, unless someone can chase after him. But Drugovich, Verstappen, Tsunoda, they're all attacking me. This is a nightmare for us. Nightmare. This is so frustrating, especially because we were trying to chase after our bitter rival, Gasly, and now it's turned into, all of a sudden, we're down to P4. Drugovich and Verstappen have overtaken us. We're going to keep trying to dig deep and maybe fighting back. You know, it was a losing battle not having DRS ourselves and all of them chasing after us. But now we're the ones chasing with DRS. But look at the amount of lifting I had to do through that final corner just to make the corner. But we've opened DRS. We used a little bit of battery. Verstappen goes for the move to the inside. We're going to go and make the double pass round the outside. It's a fantastic overtake. Rear diffuser damage, what? Absolutely not a problem there at turn one. It's a slow enough corner where it didn't really matter too much. And to be honest, it's more just the confidence that we had under brakes to get that done, to get to the apex. But now lap 28 is Porcher overtakes Drugovich. Verstappen is coming back at us. We're just about going to keep ahead and get the elbow out to defend him. And thankfully, maybe for my sake, poor chair now is now on the back of Verstappen. So what a recovery this is turning into for Teo Porcher. It's a really great move on the outside of the Ferrari. P19 to third place. This is really big for him. But Tsunoda is also knocking on the door as he goes round the outside of the Ferrari to try and also get Verstappen on this lap. But poor old Drugovich, he's already down to P7 now. He's in a Mercedes sandwich as he's really falling out of pace. Tsunoda is going to get Verstappen, and that's going to complete the demise of Verstappen and Drugovich in this race. They're both falling down the order. And Tsunoda, once he books in and finishes this move, is now going to look to focus on Teo Porcher. And that's good for me, at least, because it keeps them busy and away from me. Gasly, meanwhile, on the third last lap, dominating this one, nearly 6.5 seconds ahead of me in second place. We are just about under a second ahead of Porcher, and Tsunoda is now going for that move on our teammate. I was kind of worried Porcher was going to be the one attacking us. You know, that would have been a bit awkward trying to defend our teammate. You know, I don't want to hold him up for the sake of the team, but individually I do want to hold him up because he'll then gain more points on this in the championship. But this way now, I won't feel guilty about trying to defend anyone for second place, because it won't be my teammate attacking me, it'll be Tsunoda. So here we are then. It's not for first place, but we're once again here on the last lap. Tsunoda chasing after us to try and get our position. And massive amount of marbling on the left-hand side there and the right. Ridiculous stuff. We go so wide off the exit of turn two. Tsunoda is sniffing around. We're moving about to try and defend a little bit and just maybe put Tsunoda off. But as we go down the hill now into the heart of sector two, we're defending the inside. But Tsunoda is going for the move maybe on the outside. He's got better grip. You can tell he's got more grip on the hard tyres. And I'm just limping along. You can tell mid-apex that I've not got the rear downforce that I had before with the diffuser damage. And it means Tsunoda is all over the back of us. He's going again. And look how quick that Aston Martin is. He's on the outside. He's going for it. We're going to just maybe stay ahead. He's actually still there on the inside. We're wrestling the car through, fighting the marbles, fighting the grip, the lack of grip with the downforce and the tyres. Here Gasly has won the Spanish Grand Prix, his first win with his new team Audi, and we hold off Tsunoda for second.
Natalie Pinkham, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
Well, what an amazing race today. Everywhere you looked, there were masterful overtakes, so daring, so controlled. Late on the brakes always keeps us on the edge of our seats.
Alfa Romeo have been winning fans the world over with their brilliant driving, showing that they're a force to be reckoned with out there on the track. They'll certainly be building on that fan base after today's excellent results.
It's a good win by Gasly. I've got to hand it to him. It's a good win. It's annoying that he obviously hit us earlier in the race. We've gained points on Porsche, Tsunoda as well, so the championship gets ever closer. And maybe now Gasly could start cooking. Who knows? But if you've enjoyed it, hit the like button. Let me know what you thought in the comments below. If you're around here, then do get subscribed for weekly Formula 1 content. I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.